Hey folks, I've been debating whether or not to make this video because it's kind of personal. But I helped a friend to do a budget the other day and helped him figure out how to do that. And he was so psyched that like I thought, you know what, if it helped him, maybe it'll help somebody else. So, here, check this out. I made this in our pottery studio. And I have pottery studio merchandise now for sale, so in the link below you can find a link to that. So this video is all about money and how to save it. Now, how do you save money like this and to put in your money cup so that you can have more money? You'll be drinking money coffee. But how do you do that? Well, first off, you have to figure out how much money you need to spend every month. Everybody's got bills, right? The only way you're going to get a hold on your spending is if you know exactly how much money is going out every month, okay? So, here's how I do it. There's a million ways to do this, but this is the way I do it, okay? So here, I hope this helps you. Now, you're going to have your own different expenses, right? Everybody's got different, I mean, there's some basic things that everybody has, right? You have a place to live. You maybe have transportation to and from work. Hopefully, if you have a job, there's food, like all that. So here's the basic categories that I have, and you can copy mine, and it'll give you a template, and then you can elaborate. You can get out there from there and customize it to your own. So so I own a house. So it's actually a duplex, and We have to pay the water, so we pay the water bill. So the water bill comes in every month, and there's two lines coming in this house. So my significant other and I, we split all the bills 50-50. So this is half of the combined total of both water bills. And here's what I do. What I do is, you can see that this varies a little bit from month to month. So if it goes up, well, actually, I didn't do it on this one, but if it goes up, I usually draw an up arrow from month to month so that I can quickly look and see, like, oh, that went down, that went down, that went down. Oh, that bill went up. Why did that go up? You know, and I can, so if I need to check things out, like maybe there's a water leak, you know, this is a good way for me to find things like that out. Or if I want to renegotiate my phone bill, you know, because it went up, I can call and say, hey, why, you know, what's going on here? Sewage. I get billed for that every 3 months. So in order to figure that out, we have two lines. So we combine the totals from the two sewage bills, and then I divide by six, which is 3 months, two people, six. Three times two is six, right? So the total amount of both sewage bills added together, divided by six, comes out to be a little less than $20 a month. Garbage. I get billed for that once a year. So take that total bill, divide by 24. It's 12 months, two people, split two ways, right? So I end up with the privilege of having somebody come to my house basically and take away anything that I need them to take away is $16.25. Car insurance, that's half of our car insurance bill. Netflix. Netflix just went up in December, so I look at that. So, you know, at some point I'd say, you know, do we really need Netflix? Well, she likes it, I don't. It's not that I don't like it, I just don't watch it that much. I'm making YouTube videos or I'm watching YouTube videos, but that's okay. So, you know, it's still a negligible expense. We can afford it for now. But if we needed to get rid of something, that would go. This is our mortgage. That's half our mortgage. Gas, we pay for gas. We actually split that three ways. We split that with our tenant. Our tenant pays a third of the combined gas bills because I don't know why we did it that way. Instead of letting them pay for their own gas bill, it's not a big deal though. Health insurance. So this is a placeholder for you to put your health insurance in there. Right now, fortunately, we're getting health insurance through my significant other's place of work. So that's huge. This is a car payment. This is our phone bills. Or a phone bill divided by two. I know. That is not frugal at all. That is definitely a luxury expense. And that was one thing that would definitely go if for some reason if we really needed to pull back, this would have to go. And it pains me to pay this much every month. Electric bill is pretty tight. That's our cable and internet. We don't really have a cable package. We have the basic package because we just need the internet. I don't really watch network TV except like I watch the Super Bowl. This is a lot higher for a lot of people, but I don't even like paying this much. But you know, it is what it is. I got to have the internet, and then this is what we pay for groceries. Now, these are the basic categories that I use. There are a few categories that other people might have in their budget that I don't have listed here. Big one is clothing. There are a lot of people that enjoy spending money on clothing. I personally am not a slave to fashion. That's why I have this. But I'm not a slave to fashion at all. I have enough clothes for work and for what I do at home. So and in between, and I've acquired a very simple wardrobe. And I do have, outside of this budget, I do have a discretionary amount of money that I can use each month for myself. For money that I make, that I can spend money on if I want to, and clothes or a luxury item. I don't budget that in. Also, gasoline or transportation costs. If you take the bus and you need a bus pass, that should be in your budget. If you have a car and you have to pay for gas, that should be in the budget. So we actually have our gas under groceries. Groceries actually ends up being a lumped category. I know that seems like a lot of money for groceries for two people, doesn't it? But that includes anytime we eat out, that's basic groceries. It also includes gasoline, and it also includes minor house stuff, like home repair stuff. So if we need a can of paint or, we need a part for the dryer, so I have to fix the dryer, that sort of thing. Which brings me to another point. When I was young and just starting out, what I did was I overestimated. Once I found out what my bills were, my actual totals were, I overestimated all of these. So I would have gone 20, 20, 20, 50, 10. I would have rounded up to like the nearest $5 or $10. And that way, and if that's sustainable, if that total is sustainable based on what I'm making and how much I comfortably need to spend on myself just to like make sure that I'm feeling good about myself and I can buy things that I, a couple things that I want within reason, then I leave that money in my account. And what that does is that gradually builds up an emergency fund for things like when the car breaks down, for things like when the dryer breaks down. That sort of thing. But I can go into all that in another video. So basically, this is a basic outline that anybody is welcome to steal from me and use in order to set up their own budget on a monthly. This is a monthly budget. And if you guys have any questions or suggestions for the next video, go ahead and put them in the comments below. A thumbs up is huge for me right now, especially because work is really tight right now. This is pandemic related, but I don't need to go into all that. Thank you so much for all of your support out there. I love you guys. You guys have been an inspiration for me through this time. And I hope that if this helps you, you can help me by liking. And I hope that you go out and help somebody else today because it'll make you feel good. Just like making these videos makes me feel good if I'm helping you. So let me know if that happens. Have a great day. Hope you guys take care. Be safe.